Have you ever spent a November in rainy Manchester, UK? What about a winter in Utqiagvik, USA? If you have, you'll know what a downer it can be living without much sunshine. You might even suffer from seasonal affective disorder or SAD, which might not be classified as a mood disorder these days, but experts still tell us that going without sunshine does affect the moods of many people. Some folks even buy themselves a lamp and just sit in front of it, hoping some happiness chemicals will flood the brain. That's known as bright light therapy. We love the sun, and a lack of those calming rays leads to a humdrum existence for some. But what would happen if we totally went without it? That's what we'll find out today in this episode of the Infographics Show. What would happen if you don't see the sun for a year? For a long time, it was said that people did indeed suffer from depression as a direct result of not having enough sunshine in their lives. It's understandable, given that we often associate sunshine with happiness. Just look at how many pop songs relate sunny days to being full of joy. Nonetheless, according to the U.S. National Institute of Health, the explanations for the relationships between seasonal changes and exacerbations of psychopathology remain unclear. Studies tell us a lack of sunshine could lead to a depletion of our favorite brain chemical, serotonin, and there is evidence of people killing themselves because of too much darkness. It's thought, but not conclusive, that sunlight traveling through the retina and into the central nervous system might trigger releases of serotonin. It's also thought that sunlight on the skin may influence serotonin levels. But does that mean everyone in Yuma, Arizona is jumping for joy each and every sunny day? Does it mean citizens of some of those dark Norwegian towns spend every fall sharpening their cutthroat razors in time for the long winter? Not at all. It's not that simple. Okay, so let's get down to business. We know lack of sunlight can make some people unhappy, but what if we didn't get any sunlight on us for a whole year? If the sun went out, we don't need to tell you it would be a disaster. No sun means no life on Earth. Well, the Earth retains some heat, and it takes sunlight 8.5 minutes to get to us, so we'd be okay for a short while. In a matter of days, temperatures would be lower than minus 100, and bar some microorganisms living below the Earth, most living things would freeze and die. But let's look at a more realistic scenario. After all, some people on this planet might go to work in the dark, stay in an office all day, and then go home in the dark. As we know, those people not getting any sun would suffer from a lack of vitamin D, because sunshine gives us that. Most health experts will tell you that getting at least 5 to 15 minutes of sun on your skin every other day is a good thing. This is because the sun's ultraviolet radiations can make our bodies create this vitamin. Don't put your factor 50 away yet though, because as you know, too much of this radiation can cause skin cancer, cataracts, or even cause latent viruses to activate. But how much sun should we get? One size doesn't fit all. The National Institute of Health tells us a half hour in the summer sun in a bathing suit can initiate the release of 50,000 international units, or 1.25 milligrams of vitamin D into the circulation within 24 hours of exposure. This same amount of exposure yields 20,000 to 30,000 IUs in tanned individuals and 8,000 to 10,000 IU in dark-skinned people. That's a good amount to get. Sitting under the bright sun all day, however, as those crazy tanners like to do, is thought to be dangerous. If you go without a little bit of sunshine in your life, it could cause disease and weaken the bones. The Clinical Journal of the American Society of Nephrology tells us that people living in places that don't get much sun have a higher chance of getting colon cancer, Hodgkin's lymphoma, ovarian cancer, high blood pressure, pancreatic cancer, and prostate cancer. A few hundred years ago, it's said many people in Northern Europe, mainly children, suffered from rickets, a weakening of the bones, because they weren't getting enough sunlight. In the 19th century, doctors realized that by exposing these sun-starved kids to UVR via mercury or carbon arc lamps could help reduce the number of rickets cases. It worked, too. Doctors then realized that instances of tuberculosis could also be reduced by getting some sun on the skin. This became known as phototherapy. And it's written that such a therapy produced a radical shift in how we thought about our shiny friend in the sky. People were told by doctors to get more sun even to treat wounds, but also diabetes, ulcers, rheumatic disorders, and gout. We also realized decades later that too much sun might cause certain cancers such as melanoma, basal cell carcinoma, and squamous cell carcinoma. Some of those pale Brits that went over to sunny Australia could have told you that. Anyhow, scientists generally agree that we should get enough sun to produce vitamin D. How much is enough is still up for debate. The World Health Organization tells us to practice moderation, which means getting out under the sun for about 10 minutes a few times a week. That should be easy, right? Well, tell that to those folks living in Manchester who do those dawn until dusk shifts through the winter. Back to our main question, what if we went a year without sunlight? Well, the best answer to this question would be to look at people who actually did that. It's said that a total lack of vitamin D could lead to death, because it would cause low calcium levels that could lead to spasms in the larynx. Worst case scenario of this happening is suffocation. That doesn't generally happen though, because we get vitamin D in food such as eggs, fish, juice, and cheese. That's why when the media a few years ago reported that a religious sect in Kazan, Russia had been living underground for around a decade, they weren't all disease-ridden or dead. Some of the children aged between 1 and 17 have never seen daylight, wrote the UK's Telegraph. Members of this Islamic sect were arrested, and the kids were sent to hospital for checkups. But from what we can see, they were in okay health. Not surprisingly though, if you look at photos of these kids, they were kinda pasty, to say the least. So we know that lack of sun can make us sick in some ways, but we also know that we can live without it. But what effect would a total lack of sun have on our minds? Would we all be glum, listening to Radiohead's OK Computer on repeat and reading antinatalism photography, the position that life is so painful we should never have been born? Well, The Atlantic wanted to know the answer to this. One of the magazine's journalists went to Tromsø, Norway, where people live with a polar night that lasts an entire winter. Okay, that's not a year, but imagine living in darkness for a few months. The article cited a study conducted by BMC Psychiatry about the people of this town. Were all those folks depressed? The outcome was that the people of Tromsø were no more depressed during winter than people in cities in the US. The Atlantic writer spent the entire winter there and said he just got used to it. The darkness had an appeal of its own. He concluded, "As someone who moved from New Jersey to Georgia because I hated the cold, my personal experiment in wintertime mindset has left me convinced that with the right mindset, it's easy to love the polar night." In conclusion, we can say that we should all get some sun on our skin a few times a week, and we believe that sunlight can promote happiness. Saying that, we could live without sunlight for a year and we could adjust to it mentally. We just wouldn't want to do that, as the outcome would likely be ill health for some. But how about you? What's the longest you've been without sun? How did it affect you? Do you live in one of those cities that doesn't get much sun in the winter? Have you been in that cycle for months of getting up and going somewhere in the dark and getting home in the dark? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called "What If You Never Left the Bathtub?" Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!